gosh. You're welcome, Minnie.
Golly, Mickey. A new wristwatch. Gosh, look at the time.
Ooh, we can't be late for our very own show. Hurry, everybody.
Roll, roll, roll. Hey, wait for me.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Welcome to the show. Oh, that was close.
Merry Christmas, everybody! Merry Christmas, happy holidays, and welcome! It's Christmas morning at Walt Disney World in Florida.
Children, evergreens and sleigh rides too. Carols, shining lights, and joy brand new. This is the magic time when dreams do come true.
Celebrating our 10th anniversary live from sunny Florida, it's the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. With our parade hosts, Joan Lunden and Regis Philbin, along with Christmas correspondents Ed McMann at the Disney MGM Studios, Miss America Leanza Cornett at EPCOT Center, and John Davidson, inviting you to share all the magic and enchantment of a sparkling Disney Christmas. See your favorite Aladdin characters come to life in the world television premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan. Kick up your heels in an old-fashioned hoedown as the Disney gang celebrates the grand opening of Splash Mountain. Catch a behind-the-scenes look at the making of Aladdin, Disney's newest animated feature. Share the magic of an around-the-world Christmas at EPCOT Center with Miss America Leanza Cornett. Say hello to Beauty and the Beast in a spectacular stage show from the Disney MGM Studios. Go behind the scenes for a look at Mickey's Toontown, a brand new land at Disneyland in California. Plus, special appearances by Home Improvement's Richard Karn and Earl Hindeman, The Little Mermaid, Snow White, Cinderella, Mickey, Minnie, and the whole Disney gang. Now let's go down to Main Street, USA in the Magic Kingdom and join the University of Florida Gator Marching Band for the start of a very merry Christmas parade.
Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Actually, we've got two fabulous parades for you and lots of special Disney surprises.
Everything from the world premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan to Joan and me riding in this calliope down Main Street. Joan, I love this parade.
It's a lot of fun, so stick around for a magical Christmas morning because we've got lots of Disney treats coming your way. Merry Christmas.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Kissimmee St. Cloud, Florida, the vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction. And Pepto-Bismol, the one that coats, is the only one you need. And Post Fruity and Cocoa Pebble cereals. It's fun to start your day with Fred and Barney's favorite bedrock breakfast. Pebbles are yabba-dabba delicious.
A beautiful day in Florida, in Orlando at Walt Disney World. Welcome back to the 1992 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. We are coming to you live from sunny Florida. Gorgeous day.
It sure is. And this is something of about a year for us. This is our 10th anniversary show. And Joan Lunden, the mother of us all, has been here for all 10
Come
of
on.
Those years.
You've been here for nine That's of right. those years, Regis. EPCOT Center had just opened when we started here. Since then, we have seen the opening of the Disney MGM Studios, all kinds of new resorts, new attractions. I mean, these Disney people, they're always outdoing themselves.
And they are still building, as we have seen. Yeah, it looks like they've done it again. This morning, we have such a big show. We put a Christmas correspondent, listen, a Christmas correspondent in every park all
That's
around
true.
Here just to keep
He's
us
right.
up to date on all the excitement.
And right now, the star of the incredible Holiday Splendor stage show over at EPCOT Center, John Davidson, is down on Main Street here in the Magic Kingdom with a few of the people who are celebrating Christmas with us this morning. Merry Christmas, John.
Hi, John.
Okay, one, two, three. Merry Christmas, Joan and Regis. Oh, this is a crowd here we've got today. We have people from all over the world, and I'll tell you one thing. They are in the Christmas spirit, right? We have people here from, where are you from?
Oh, we came from Japan.
From Japan, all the way, year after year. From back there, where are you from? North Carolina. I see, okay. I know where you're from.
Toronto.
Toronto, and they are the world champs. We know that now. Has anyone seen Aladdin, the wonderful picture? All right, do we have a surprise for you? Let's visit Ed McMann, our Christmas correspondent over at the Disney MGM Studios, because they're getting ready for a fabulous new thing. The world premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan. It's a brand new parade featuring all the characters from Aladdin. You'll love the parade over at Disney MGM Studios. Let's go to Aladdin and Merry Christmas, Ed McMann.
Merry Christmas, John. I'm here with some Christmas fans of my own back here. Now, everyone's busy getting ready for this fantastic new parade. We've got harem girls and camels and acrobats, even Aladdin and Princess Jasmine in person. Aladdin's Royal Caravan promised to be a showstopper in true Disney style. Today, we're unveiling it for the world to see for the very first time. It's going to be a great addition to the Disney MGM Studios, the most popular movie and TV studio in the world. Now, it's my second home since Star Search has made it its home here.
Time to get ready.
Oh, okay. Listen, I gotta go right now. We gotta get ready for that big parade. Before I do, allow me to introduce a former Walt Disney World cast member, Miss America 1993, Leanza Cornett, our Christmas correspondent over at EPCOT Center. Here she is, Miss America.
Merry Christmas, Ed. It is great to be back at Walt Disney World. There's no place like home for the holidays, and home for me is right here in Florida, especially when I can be at EPCOT Center with some very special friends who really love Christmas. For me, the best time to be at Disney is the holidays. Sharing the magic of this special season is always a treat. And today we've got a fabulous Christmas show for you. We'll be back in just a few minutes with an EPCOT Center Christmas around the world and a warm Christmas greeting from some very special children. But right now, we've got a parade to see. So take it away, Joan and Regis.
And thank you, Leanza, and Merry Christmas. And join us now as we begin the 10th anniversary of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. There are our banner elves, Reed. They're here
them.
With us every single year to kick off this parade.
I tell you, the elves do most of the work around here. It's good to see them out there.
Yeah, they're the hardest working elves in snow business.
That's right. Here are the knights, those colorful costumes.
They're the very bravest knights.
Oh, there
hey,
they are.
Look who here, the stars of our show.
Oh, gosh, the first couple of Disney World. Really enjoying it.
Mickey Mouse, do you know he has over 80 different costumes here at Walt Disney World? Everything from a scuba suit to a tuxedo.
And did you know Mickey Mouse, 65 years old?
He doesn't look like it.
No, he sure
look
doesn't.
A little mini there. And Pluto, their best friend. Now they're coming down Main Street, and that's the Christmas tree you're looking at there. That Christmas tree is 80 feet tall, which is 15 feet higher than the one at Rockefeller Center.
It's one of the biggest ones in the country, if not the biggest. And there's a shot from the Christmas tree looking right down Main Street, right over the
Magic Castle. Right up at the tippy top of that tree they put a camera. Another Christmas tradition for us is Major Mike Davis.
He's a real-life music man, too. He went over to Euro Disney and taught the French, you know, how to put this parade together. He's a terrific guy.
He's been here every single year, and he, I should say, is also the proud father of three, so he's kind of Disney's own major dad.
Sure is. Yeah, we're underway right now. When I see this band come down, I know it's begun.
Now, every Christmas season, they really deck this place out. You've seen this every year. There are 4 miles of garland around the place, 3,500 wreaths, and get this, 850 Christmas trees all over all of these parks.
I asked the other day, what do they do with all of this? It takes 2 huge warehouses to store it all.
Now, if those knights are there, Cinderella can't be far away, and here she comes.
And Joan, Lunden, she's waving to me right now. Every year she waves. Hi, Cinder, how you doing?
I know that kiss was for you, Reed.
Crazy
I know
about
it was.
Me. Yes, Cinderella. She wants to make sure I got the kiss.
Arriving, of course, in her pumpkin coat.
She's still blowing those
She
kisses.
Has her own castle, and there's her Prince Charming. Hey, he's a pretty good-looking guy, too.
Well, but you know, he's a nice guy, but he always had trouble meeting the right lady until, of course, he met the prince.
And there's the little fairy godmother and Susie and Perla. I mean, they really made all this happen, of course. If it wasn't for the fairy godmother, that coach would never be there.
You're absolutely right. They turned the mice into horses. They did it all. I could use them.
Part of the crowd. Lined. On Main Street, here are royal dancers from the court of Cinderella, and all these beautiful costumes, of course, come right out of the fairy tale.
They're performing a very elegant duet. There's the whole shot there, the band and the dancers and Cinderella, and the tremendous crowd we have here on Christmas morning.
Hi, everybody. Yeah, go ahead, wave, say hi. Everybody
Sometimes I think the costumes on the sidelines are pretty colorful, too.
3,500 different designs, different costumes in this parade. It's amazing.
It's a fabulous parade. I really think this is going to be one of the best ones in history, too.
Well, the best news of all is that the fun has just begun. Coming up soon, we've got a visit with Beauty and the Beast and a look at the smash hit film Aladdin. So stick around because we'll be right back with much, much more.
Hi, I'm Valerie Harper. And I'm here at the Disney MGM Studios theme park. And I want to wish you the happiest of holidays and a fantastic new year. Here's to 1993.
More Very Merry Christmas Parade and a behind-the-scenes look at Disney's smash animated hit Aladdin when we return.
Oh, Tigger, put that over there on the left. That looks wonderful. Oh, the lights will be perfect there. Thank you. Hurry, everybody. We just got to finish decorating Mickey's house. It's Christmas.
Gosh, Minnie, we're doing our best. Whoa. Yeah.
Almost got it, Minnie. Whoa, whoa.
Ow, help. Get me out of this mess.
We'll help. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, you guys need a hand over here?
Thank you, Al. That would be wonderful.
Looks like you could use a little help around here.
Oh,
now, Donald, how'd you get yourself in a mess like this, huh? All right, Chip, Dale, I'll need a wrench, a screwdriver, and a large nut.
Coming right up.
Now, what are these, 5-watt, 10-watt? You know, I use these on my house. Yeah, but I don't wrap it around my head.
Hope these nuts aren't too big.
No, that's great. I work with a larger nut than that every week.
Now, Al, I don't know if I'd talk about Tim that way. I mean, he has got his problems, sure. Maybe he's even a little bit eccentric, but as I always say...
Yeah, right, Wilson. Hold that thought for a minute. Goofy, do you have a file?
Here you go.
I don't think so, Goofy.
Gee, everything looks great, Al.
Well, you guys, looks like you got it all put together now. Looking good. Yes, sir. Well, come on, Wilson. We gotta go. You know, Tim can't do without us.
I'm on my way, Al. And Merry Christmas to everyone.
Yes, yes. Well, Merry Christmas to you all, too. You know, the only thing I regret is I wasn't able to wish Mickey a Merry Christmas, too. Where is that boy?
Well, hi-ho, mousy neighbor.
Hi, Wilson.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, and Merry Christmas to everybody.
I recognize that little hand back there. Thank you, Richard Karn and Earl Hindman, for that bit of holiday home improvement. Welcome back, everyone. We are coming to you live from sunny, gorgeous, beautiful day in Florida.
And as we told you, this year's Merry Christmas Parade happens to be the best of all. Every year, something new here. And coming up, we've got the world premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan. I saw that movie last night. Plus visits to the Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast.
Right now, though, we're going to go back down to Main Street for a visit with another Disney great, and it is Snow White. And I know those little guys, the seven dwarves, led by, look who's out there, Frosty the Snowman is leading
them. Frosty the Snowman leading those dwarfs around.
Made of a very special snow that doesn't melt.
Uh-huh.
Which is very important
on a day like this. Day like this is right.
Now, who are those children up there?
They're too big to be yours.
There's my Jamie.
Wow.
Lindsay and Sarah. And you know who else that is? That's Ashley. That's John Davidson's little girl there. Jamie's got her hand on her shoulder.
Uh-huh.
Here are our guys. Can you name them?
Well, there's Dopey, there's Doc, there's Sneezy, Happy,
Sleepy,
Grumpy. Who's the last one?
Bash.
And Bashful, of course.
Of course.
You know, some of the names that were rejected years ago when they put this together?
Okay, go ahead, lay them on us.
Wheezy, Burpee.
That's one of my favorites. Baldy.
Baldy and Big Ego.
We know a few of those, right?
We sure know a few of those is right. You kids are getting big, aren't they?
I know.
Didn't I catch the 9-year-old in high heels last night?
Yes, you did.
Wow.
They're very excited to be on Snow White's float, though, because they've always loved Snow White. It's a favorite of theirs. As she happens to be right behind, we'll see her in a minute.
You know, this movie, Snow White, created more hit songs than any other Disney movie in the past. Six of them made the hit parade in 1938, and there she is.
There she is, Snow White, along with her prince, of course.
She's saying, I love you.
He's got that kiss that can work miracles.
That's right. Joan, this was the highest grossing film of all time until Gone with the Wind came along.
Wow.
And still being released. Disney's first movie heroine, fairest in the land.
Now you know who's down there, of course.
I know
John
who's down
Davidson
there.
Is down there where all the action is on Main Street. John.
Action kind of guy.
Hi, Joan and Regis. Well, everybody comes here year after year. As a matter of fact, some people get here so early, this baby is less than a month old. And she was born here while they've been waiting in line for the parade, I think. Yeah. Hi, everybody. Having a great time?
Yeah!
Great! Is there anybody here who's seen the movie Aladdin? Let me come down here. We've got so many. Where are you from?
New Jersey.
Hi. Where are you from?
Hi.
Hi, sir. Do you come to the parade each year?
Yeah.
Well, it's nice to see you. You look amazingly like one of the Disney people. I don't know. You look wonderful, though. You want to say hi to the folks at home? Everybody in your family look this way?
Yes, it's hereditary.
So where are you from?
East Brentwood, New York.
From New York, great. Say hi to everybody in your neighborhood. Let them know the house is deserted, the car has been left there. Maybe they'll go see your house. You know, the movie Aladdin is on its way to becoming a Disney classic, and I'm so glad you reminded me of it. There's never been an animated feature with so much comedy and adventure all rolled into one. Now, the folks that made the movie didn't just rub a lamp, you know, to make Aladdin. It was a lot of hard work. 600 artists and performers and technicians brought it all to the screen. That ancient tale is so wonderful. Many of those people are in the animation studios right here at Walt Disney World. Did you know that? No! Let's take a look at how it was all done.
It's probably the most famous story of the Arabian Nights tales. It's about a poor kid, a kid from the streets. He sort of lives by his wits.
I'm in trouble.
Then he falls in love with a beautiful princess.
Wow.
Hello. There's an evil magician. There's a magical genie that can grant wishes.
So what'll it be, Master?
Aladdin gets the lamp, which seems like the greatest thing in the world, but Aladdin finds out that it's not quite as great as it might seem on the surface.
On every character that you're animating, no matter whether it's a mermaid or a beast or an eagle or it's Aladdin, it has to be something that I've experienced personally.
One of the things that inspired me the most with Aladdin was Hammer's Can't Touch This video. I felt like, Aladdin has got to have that kind of spark.
One jump ahead of the bread line, one swing ahead of the sword. I steal only what I can't afford. That's everything.
Jasmine is kind of a feisty little princess. She wants to really explore life for herself.
Father, I hate being forced into this.
If I do marry, I want it to be for love.
Oh, to think we gotta keep kissing up to that chump!
The character I play is basically it's a parrot because I fit. It was an obnoxious parrot. If it was a nice parrot, they'd hire someone else.
Gilbert's delivery is so specific with the shut eyes and a big mouth and the teeth showing all the time. That really dictates that we've got a parrot with a big mouth, great big teeth, his eyes are shut, and he's always gesturing with this frustration.
You start from the story, you start from the characters and where the plot goes, and you have a number that expresses what the character wants, what his dreams are, his or her dreams are.
Prince Ali, fabulous he, Ali Ababa. Genuflect, show some respect down on one knee.
He can have anything, go anywhere, be anyone that he wants to. And the movie in the end is about the discovery that his own self-confidence and his own self-reliance, who he is, in the end, is more powerful and more valuable than all of these wonderful things that he has at his command.
Coming up next, a splash-tacular celebration at the grand opening of Splash Mountain in the Magic Kingdom.
That's the Grand Floridian, and you're looking at the castle, the main house here in this magical residence.
What a terrific shot coming right over that body of water.
And there it is, right behind us. Everybody always asks us, is this in studio or are we really here live? We are.
It's there.
But we pray for birds to fly through the shot. Welcome back, everyone, to sunny Florida. We are here live with the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, and it's a wonderful day.
And remember, I'm the one who told you it's the best one ever, and you can quote me on that.
And we still have much more to come, including a sneak preview of a brand new land at Disneyland in California, Mickey's Toontown. Right now, though, let's visit with the residents of the 100-acre woods. You know these guys, Winnie the Pooh and all his friends. There's the honeypot right there. This is a new float, you know, Reed.
Oh, it is a new float.
Uh-huh.
Yes, that's right.
Made up just for this year's
parade. Temperature's gone up 2 degrees. It's 72 now. Lovely day. Now, let's see. What does that little tag say? To Pooh from Pooh.
That's right. There's Tigger, the guy that likes to bounce around. And Winnie, I love Eeyore.
Tigger's my favorite, Joan. Come on.
Well, you remind me a little of Tigger. He's going to bounce around everywhere.
Huh? Now, Winnie the Pooh is one of your girls' favorite characters,
yes,
right?
Absolutely. Oh, now, there's a shot from the helicopter looking down there on Main Street. The honeypot's right down there.
Yeah, there
it is. You see at the bottom of Main Street. That huge Christmas tree, 80 feet tall.
Wow. Spectacular.
Oh, look at her in her little Minnie Mouse outfit.
And her Mickey ears or her Minnie ears.
Hey, there's the owl there on Pooh Tree.
That means Kanga should be hanging around,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he's the wisest owl of all, and he hangs out there with Kanga. Little baby Roo in the pocket.
It's all based on that 100 acres of English countryside where it all began.
Now, the absolute tallest, biggest float in this parade is the riverboat, the showboat.
Song of the South, another of the great Disney classics. Yeah, it is the biggest, tallest boat of them all. A little piece of the old Mississippi with the showboat dancers right in front of it there.
Yeah, now look up front there. You know those guys, Brer Rabbit, Brer Bear, and Brer Fox.
And they're all getting along. Everybody gets along on Christmas morning, even those three. Oh, look at her.
Brer Fox is that sly little rascal. He always wants to have Brer Rabbit for dinner, and I don't mean as a guest.
I know. It's amazing that they're all there.
And the big guy, I mean, Brer Bear, he's such a clumsy brute. He's so gullible. He ends up helping Brer Rabbit to outwit Brer Fox, and I don't really think he even knows he does it.
Brer Fox is the smartest of them all, right? He's a sly rascal.
Yeah.
And there are the Dixieland musicians playing Bayou Christmas. Amazing how Disney is able to take what we see in the movies and transfer it to this parade. Beautifully done.
Now, earlier this year, Brer Rabbit and his friends invited everyone out to a grand opening of the splashtacular new attraction here at the Magic Kingdom, Splash Mountain. Let's see what all the excitement's about with our Christmas correspondent, John Davidson.
Hit that mountain, John. Come on.
Space Mountain, move over Big Thunder Mountain, because here is Splash Mountain. This is the newest addition to the Magic Kingdom mountain range, and this place is wild. You've got an eye-popping ride through backwood bayous and scenic swamps, and it ends in a five-story drop, which is simply splash-tackler. Let's go over to the end of the ride and see what they think. I'm not sure I should try. Things that drop down, I don't know. Let me see. How'd you like it?
Oh, wonderful.
How was it?
Spiffing, old boy.
Boy, you really got wet. Should I go on it? Is it okay?
You'll love it.
All right, I'm gonna try it. Yeah, this is fabulous. You know, back on opening day, they came across a little problem with Splash Mountain, no water. But that didn't seem to dampen the festivities. Let's take a look.
Such a hurry.
We's leaving.
Use what?
We's leaving.
Well, what do you want to do that for?
Why, you can't open a Splash Mountain when that mountain ain't got no water.
No water?
No water.
No water?
Hey, everybody, here's Brer Bear. Maybe he can help us.
Listen to me, Brer Bear. We're in a peck of trouble. You got to help us. You got to get up there and make that water come rushing down that flume. So go on up there, Brer Bear, and save the day.
Watch this.
With me, we'll open the steepest, wettest, most splash-tacular place in the whole world!
1, 2, 3, Splash Mountain! Zip-a-dee-doo-da! Zip-a-dee-doo-da! Wonderful, wonderful day! Zip-a-dee-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-zip-
Beast and the Little Mermaid are coming up soon, so don't go away. The 10th annual Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Ooh. Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Hi, I'm Biscuit.
I'm Gumby.
I'm Jamie.
And I'm Darren.
And we're
Classic Example.
We're here at Walt Disney World's EPCOT Center, and we just want to wish everyone a
very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Got that?
Word.
Got that?
Word.
I got it. I'm Joni.
And I'm Biscuit.
Nice number, though, from Classic Example. They've got a new single called It's All Right.
Yeah, they sound great. Well, everything's better than all right around here at the Very Merry Christmas Parade. Coming to you live, and what a morning it's been so far. But wait, we've got more. Listen to this. Miss America coming up, a visit to Disneyland in California for a brand new segment of the park out there, and the world premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan just a few minutes away.
But first, let's take a look at another Disney animated hit, Beauty and the Beast.
You know, I went over and saw it again at the park the other night. What a great, great, beautiful score.
Yeah, and all that wonderful music comes to life at the Disney MGM Studios in Beauty and the Beast live on stage. Wonderful show. Since it premiered last year, the stage show has become one of Disney's most popular attractions of all time. If you take a look, you'll see why.
There she goes, the girl is so peculiar. I wonder if she's feeling well.
With a dreamy, far-off look.
And her nose stuck in a book.
What a puzzle to the rest of us is Belle.
Oh, isn't this amazing? It's my favorite part because you'll see.
To spare.
You shouldn't have come to the West Wing.
And you should learn how to control your temper.
Say something nice to her.
Try to act like a gentleman.
I apologize.
Apology accepted. There's something sweet and almost kind. But he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. And now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
The Beast will make off with your children. He'll come after them in the night. No one will be safe until his head is mounted on my wall. I say we kill the Beast! Through the woods, through the darkness and the shadows. It's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer and we're there at the drawbridge of a castle, and there's something truly terrible inside. It's a beast! He's got fangs, razor sharp ones, massive paws, killer claws for the beast. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead.
great movie and great show. I've seen it a number of times, and you can see it performed every day at the Disney MGM Studios. Beautiful show.
You know, it's so good that I think, really, they should take it to Broadway and do it there. And, you know, it's worthy of a Broadway show. And what a beautiful day it is here. Christmas Day in Florida. You know, with weather like this, people are bound to come up with new ways to spend the holidays. And we sent John Davidson over to the Seven Seas Lagoon to take a closer look, as only he can.
Merry Christmas, everybody. You know, Disney said, we're going to put you on a big mega yacht, John. We're going to put you out the water because you're a big celebrity, and we want to welcome you. Well, I think I got Regis's boat. I'm not sure. Anyway, I can't think of a better way to get in the holiday spirit than on a boat. Hi, Merry Christmas. What? You're here at Disney World for the holidays. You didn't want to go skiing where it's snowing? A lot more to do here. This is the way to spend Christmas, right? Listen, wait, I got a great idea. It's time for the annual John Davidson Water Ballet Christmas Sing-Along. Everybody sing with me. Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Yo, it's Christmas time with me. Well, hi, everybody. Merry Christmas. How are you?
Yeah.
Oh, you look like you've got the Christmas spirit here. What are you sitting here watching?
Oh, it's Goofy.
Yeah, he's doing great. Oh, what do we got here? Hi, kids. What are you making? That looks like a castle. And that's a tunnel. And, uh-oh, I think I know who's this guy. What's his name?
Mickey Mouse.
Oh, that looks great. Merry Christmas. Hi, everybody. Enjoying the holidays. We'll be right back. Oh! Well, some of us will be right back a little later in the show. But now let's go back and enjoy more of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Gee, I sure hope Goofy's all right, Reggie. He's scheduled to be in the parade a little later on.
I know the Goof. He's a trooper. He'll be back.
Hey, look at this energetic young group coming down Main Street is the University High Cougar Band and Guard.
Mm-hmm. One of the biggest and one of the best, too. 240 musicians are really a favorite part of many Walt Disney World special events here.
Yeah, in fact, I think the most recent appearance was at the 1992 NBA All-Star Party, which was right here at the studios.
Right. And now they're going on to the 1993 Sugar Bowl in New Orleans. Big game.
Big game, yeah.
Alabama, Miami fighting it out for number one.
That's what, New Year's Day?
On ABC. And this band has been selected to appear there at halftime.
Let's listen. Right up Main Street, all the garland across the top. I never cease to be amazed at the amount of talent on the grounds here. It's amazing.
All these beautiful young faces.
I went to the Jolly Holiday show here last night, here at right outside the Magic Kingdom at the Convention Center, the Contemporary, over 100 performers. Doing one special show. Hey, look at the hay wagon there. You know who that is.
Yeah, I know who that is.
That's the Wendell. Country Bears.
And Liver Lips and Shaker.
Now, we should say Wendell's the short one, yep. Liver Lips is the tall one, and Shaker's the other one. They came to us from the Country Bear Jamboree.
Yeah, that's right. They're so popular around here, they have their own show every night.
Yeah, over at the Grizzly Hall, which also is completely decorated for Christmas.
I used to work with the guys earlier in my career. It didn't work out too well.
So?
They were way overbearing.
Ugh,
you get it, Joe?
That was grizzly ridge. Just grizzly.
Sorry, yes.
Hey, there's the scarecrows.
Love their dance, too.
They learned this from Ray Bolger, right?
Uh-huh, absolutely. The original scarecrows.
They're out there with the Clogger Girls. They're going to be clogging to a country Christmas.
Now, why do they call them Clogger Girls?
Because way, way, way back, they used to wear heavy wooden shoes, and the wooden shoes were the actual thing that was called the clog.
I'd take anything but the name Clogger Girls, you know what I mean? But if that's what they're called, so be it. The crowd really loves it down there.
crowd. The crowds on Christmas Day are amazing. I mean, they really packed this place. Do you realize over 350 million people have visited the Walt Disney World Resort since it opened? It opened in 1971.
Wow.
Yeah, it opened in 1971. And we'll be back with more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade live from Florida right after this.
Get set for the television premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan when we return.
You are looking at the Disney MGM Studios.
It's become my favorite place, I think, here. So much going on.
Just a part of the Walt Disney World here in Orlando, Florida. Welcome back, everyone. We are coming to you live from sunny Florida. Gorgeous day. We've got a lot more of this Very Merry Christmas Parade, though, coming up.
Yep, but right now it's time to kick off the world premiere. Do you hear what I'm saying? This is the world premiere of the Aladdin Royal Caravan over at the Disney MGM Studios. Just love that place. You see real production on real sound stages, even animation created right in front of your eyes. Just like being in Hollywood.
And in true Hollywood style, the studio parade festivities begin with a spectacular opening number.
Make me a spectacle, Joan. Come on, let's see it. I love it. Got their own parade over there too at Disney.
That's right.
Disney
they come
Studios.
Down Hollywood Boulevard as opposed to coming down Main Street.
Mm-hmm.
This way, a lot more of those folks can be a part of the Christmas parade on Christmas morning.
Absolutely. Well, this has been going on since Hollywood was created, right? The tap dancing numbers.
That's right, and they have these parades, of course, all the time there at the Disney MGM Studios.
Oh, everybody looking for that big break, and it's not that outrageous. You know, our own Miss America, Leanza
Cornett. You're right.
Still got to start doing this right here in the Disney MGM Studios.
Yeah, you know, she's really, really, really good friends with the Little Mermaid. I mean, they even hang out and sing together.
That's right. Very close. Well, could one of these ladies be the next Miss America? Could be.
Could
you never
be.
Know. It's Mickey Mouse's car, but look who popped out of the top.
Ed McMahon.
Just
that
right.
Thing's 40 feet long. It's got furniture in there. It's got a bed, and it's got end tables.
It's just right for Big Ed, I'll tell you that. Look at him. He loves it.
You're going to have to talk to your agent.
Absolutely. Why am I driving a Yugo?
Well, he's getting a big welcome there on Hollywood Boulevard.
Okay. Thank you, ladies. Merry Christmas, Joan and Regis. Welcome to the Disney MGM Studios, the most popular movie and TV studios in the world, where movies come to life, including one you may have already heard about. Has anybody here seen Aladdin? Okay. Now, Aladdin is just the latest in a string of hits that some critics are calling a new golden age of Disney animation. Now, we all remember The Little Mermaid and last year's blockbuster Beauty and the Beast, the first animated film to be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar. Well, here at the Disney MGM Studios, we've some exciting new attractions based on both of those animated classics. And now a whole batch of characters are about to come to life in the one and only Aladdin's Royal Caravan. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's Genie!
That's one tall genie, 26 feet tall.
The biggest I've ever seen. And what a performance by Robin Williams playing the genie in that movie.
Was that unbelievable? You know, the story dates back to 850 AD, but the Disney artists really were able to adapt the story to appeal to every age group. It was amazing.
It's the hippiest genie I've ever heard, you know?
I thought it was Academy Award winning.
What did they say? 68 performances he does, you know, in various impersonations.
Well, it took over 500 people to bring Aladdin, to bring that story to the big screen.
And there's the magic lamp.
Yeah,
see, that's,
you know,
what I need, Joan. I need a magic lamp.
I know, but the problem is that this whole genie gig, you know, you've got these phenomenal cosmic powers, but you have to live in that little tiny living space.
Until somebody urges you out. Hey, scimitar.
Now, these are nasty guys, these scimitar guys, you know?
I know, they chased Aladdin all over the place. And it's a beautiful dance that they've constructed here just based on those cartoon characters.
They slice, they dice. They make julienne fries. Oh, look at the shot from the helicopter. You can see how big the genie is.
Just before the genie, it's that crossroads building that they have on Sunset Boulevard.
And don't you love the way these guys wear sunglasses?
Yeah, right.
They're really a cool bunch of scimitars. Of course, this is all because the genie made this come true. I mean, he wished all of this.
I love these various shots we're getting. The tree cam, the genie cam. I wonder where that next cam is going to come from. Aladdin's one of the biggest movie hits of the year so far. I love that face.
It's a face only a mother could love. It's the 31st Disney animated feature.
Is that right?
Aladdin. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And we'll be right back with more of Aladdin's Royal Caravan in just a moment.
Parade. Hey, this is the Great Gonzo down here at Walt Disney World. Merry Christmas, everybody, from the Muppets.
The Royal Caravan has just begun. Plus, a New York Christmas comes to Florida when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
That is a really nice Christmas card.
Sure is. A little season's greetings from just a few of the more than 30,000 cast members who work here at Walt Disney World.
It takes a lot of people to keep up with a 27,000-acre resort.
And how? But thank God we've got Ed McMann on the job on Hollywood Boulevard, keeping us up with Aladdin's Royal Caravan and everything else that's happening over at the studio. Ed?
Okay, thank you, Joan and Regis. We got lots more Aladdin coming your way. Now, is this fantastic or what? All right. I love parades. In fact, I've been lucky enough to host the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade for about 10 years. It was a great experience. This has been like old home week for me. The splendor of a Macy's Christmas, complete with those tremendous balloons, has arrived right here at the Disney MGM Studios. Now, have you people had a chance to look at all the balloons, have you? All right, now listen. What's your favorite balloon?
Goofy Santa.
Goofy Santa. Sometimes Santa is goofy. You see some of those prizes you get? Okay, we got folks at home to taste of what we're talking about right now. We're about to see what we do when we mix a little Disney magic with a few miracles on 34th Street. Big things are about to happen.
A Macy's New York Christmas. It's as much a holiday tradition as turkey, mistletoe, and presents under the tree. Every year, the New York holiday season kicks off with the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade and its giant helium-filled balloons
towering high above 34th Street. Now, after over 65 years in New York, all that holiday magic has flown south for the winter to the New York street on the back lot right here at the Disney MGM Studios. This year, for the first time ever, Macy's New York sent 21 of their fabulous parade balloons to recreate Christmas in New York here in Central Florida. Overnight, almost like magic, the back lot was transformed into a Christmas wonderland. Greats are here for you to see. Say hello to Snuggles the Bear. Here's the queen of the Macy's Parade, Betty Boop. The world's most lovable frog, Kermit. And there's Humpty Dumpty. Hang on there, Humpty. There's the All-American Deluxe Double Dip. At the center of all the Christmas excitement is our very own Santa Goofy. At 68 feet tall, Goofy made his debut this year at the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Balloons, though, are just the start of this Christmas story. Check out the latest feature. Hear carolers on the street corner. The entire New York street comes alive with all the magic and excitement of a Macy's New York Christmas. And it's all right here, this holiday season, only at the Disney MGM Studios.
And there they are on Hollywood Boulevard at the Disney MGM Studios. Have you had a chance to see those balloons over there? They are much bigger than you would imagine.
And at night, they're hovering over the park, and they're all lighted, and it's really a spectacular sight. Acrobats going crazy here on Hollywood Boulevard. Jeannie's been loose with them. How many do we have here? We've got about...
They're stacked upon each other. All right, here comes my favorite float. These are the... spitting camels.
Now watch, they're going to give a little exhibition right here.
These guys are getting even with everyone who loves a camel hair coat. They actually spit on the audience.
How rude.
Do you think it's good luck to get spit at?
They're
going to
do it again. No, 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 please.
There you go. The local weatherman did not predict this kind of precipitation.
Absolutely not.
And in this case, the people are carrying the camels instead of the camels carrying
the
people.
Those are dummy slaves holding up those camels. Leaving the driving up to them. Now, here you go.
All right. What the genie boy, he's a side-splitting guy or a torso-splitting guy.
And the crowd loves him, even half of them.
Well, you know, in the movie, I mean, Robin Williams, I mean, he's something different every minute.
Exactly, yeah.
He impersonates all these different people. He comes apart, he can do anything with his body. It's great.
Impersonations from Pinocchio to Arsenio Hall to my close personal friend, Robert De Niro. He does everybody as the genie.
Now, he's seen a few parades because what has he imagined into this parade?
Uh-huh.
A giant 24-foot gorilla float. And where does a 24-foot gorilla float?
Anywhere it wants to.
That's right, Reed.
Thank you, Joan.
That's nice. A shot from the helicopter. Uh-huh. You can see they're all looking up because those things are so tall. It takes 16.
Yeah.
They're called Agrabahian float carriers.
Good for
you. Like
you.
That?
Good
like
for
that?
You.
Good.
Nicely done. Yeah, 24-foot gorilla.
All right, and my other favorite. I mean, wouldn't you know it, the minute you get into the bathtub, someone goes and throws a parade, you know?
Now, here comes one of my favorite floats.
Oh, yes.
The Kier's float. Now, these guys can do just about anything they want.
We told those girls to bring their boas. They got a little carried away, you know?
Sure did. See, the fakir knows. Love this fakir float.
That was what they called social climbing back there in those days. See that guy going up that rope?
Just a couple of girls and their snakes. There he is on a bed of
nails. Have you ever felt like that on certain days?
Dressed as Santa Claus.
All right, now let's go down to Ed McMann, who's there on Hollywood Boulevard.
Yes, Ed.
As you can tell, we're having a great time here on Hollywood Boulevard. The parade is incredible, and boy, you gotta love that genie, right, huh?
Yeah!
All right, listen. You've seen the genie. Now, if you had one wish in the whole world, what would it be?
Well, I'd go to Broward Community College. I want to get straight A's.
Straight A's. That's a good wish, all right? I hope you do. I'll tell the genie personally. Okay, we're granting a lot of wishes. When we come back, lots more of Aladdin's Royal Caravan.
Hi, I'm Pierce Brosnan here at the Disney MGM Studios in Florida. I wish you a happy Christmas, God bless, and have a wonderful 93. Take care of yourselves.
Coming up, The Little Mermaid, plus an inside look at the magic of Disney animation. So don't go away.
Say it just once. Cowabunga, everybody.
Oh, I love them. Welcome back, everyone, to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Just love those turtles. You know, over at the Disney MGM Studios, you can meet them every day.
Yeah.
Not to mention R2-D2,
C-3PO,
and Indiana Jones running around, too.
And sometimes you can even meet our Christmas correspondent, Ed McMann, there. How's it going, Ed?
We're here with the world premiere of Aladdin's Royal Caravan. It's all based on Disney's latest animated feature, Aladdin. And I'll tell you, here on the street, it's just like being in the movie, which is the feeling you get all around the park all the time. Take it from me, if you like animation and animated characters, there's no place like the Disney MGM Studios to bring them all to life. Right, watch and you'll see what I mean. Put together a full-length animated film, a single sequence like this one from The Little Mermaid takes up to 1,000 individual drawings. It's a lot of work, but there's a Disney standard to uphold. And in the end, the magic is worth it.
No big deal.
Here at the Disney MGM Studios in Florida, you get to peek over the shoulders of Disney animators at work. These are the people who've breathed life into classic features, films like The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, and Aladdin. The entire process takes place before your eyes, from storyboard to ink and paint. Nowhere else can you get closer to the art of animation. And now through the magic of live stage shows and attractions, the Disney MGM Studios lets you get closer to all your favorite Disney characters too. Imagine the thrill of seeing them perform live and in person. Sit back now and enjoy this performance as we magically bring Ariel, Prince Eric, and Sebastian to life.
There you see her, sitting there across the way. Boy, she don't got a lot to see, but there's something about her. And you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the bird. Now is a moment, floating in a blue lagoon. Boy, you better do it soon, no time will be better. Don't say a word, and she won't say a word until you kiss the girl. Oh no! Sha-la-la-la-la-la, my oh my, look like the boy too shy, and gonna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, ain't that sad, ain't it a shame too much, gonna miss the girl. Did you hear that, flounder? If you don't get over there and give Ariel a big kiss on the cheek, she's gonna miss you, man. Oh, man, all the beautiful fish all around me. I want to kiss everybody. Come on in here. That's it. Get around. Get ready. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared. You got the mood prepared. Go on and kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't stop now. Don't try to hide it. How you want to kiss the girl? Kiss the girl, bud. You flounder. Kiss the girl.
Oh, there they go, the kiss. No, no, not the Almost. When you go to this live show, yeah. though, they really make you feel like you're underwater. It's great.
It's a great, great effect. It really is. And it's filled with wonderful effects.
And from a singing crab, we go back to Hollywood Boulevard for a singing genie and more of the Aladdin's Royal Caravan. Here, these are the slaves.
The jewelry slaves, yeah. Boy, there's a lot of jewelry in this parade.
Now, you know who this guy is because you just saw the movie, so you know that the little monkey,
yeah, becomes the big elephant.
He becomes the elephant, and there they are. There's Princess Jasmine, and, you know, Prince Ali just loves Princess Jasmine.
You know, he's just a poor street boy, a diamond in the rough, something like me, Joan, you know?
I don't think at this point he's actually told Jasmine that he's really Aladdin. Should we tell her?
No, that'd be snitching.
Okay. And of course, you see what they're on? The royal magic carpet. That magic carpet is like a big character in the
That's
movie.
Right. It becomes a star unto its own.
I'd like a magic carpet to zip
great?
Me off wherever I want to go.
What a terrific illusion. I mean, when you were a kid, all kinds of visions came into your head with that magic carpet.
You could fly anywhere you want. All right, now this guy is the really nasty villain, Jafar. Snarly looking guy. Of course, you'd have a snarl on your face, too, if they made you clean up after the elephants, which is what his job is today.
Does he have somebody inside the royal container there?
Yeah, I think it's little Iago, right?
Iago, still trapped. Parrot,
yeah.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
He's a really, really deliciously devilish villain.
One of Disney's all-time best. Look at him, making his way down there.
Well, remember in Little Mermaid, it was Ursula.
That's
remember
right.
Ursula, the sea witch?
Oh, the genie dances are with us now. We're heading into the grand finale of this incredible parade.
Hey, there you go. Can you do that, Reach?
I'm afraid if I got one leg up, I'd never get it down again. Oh. Genie is back.
Now, seeing him like that, doesn't that remind you of Robin Williams?
You know, it really does. They've even captured that face of Robin Williams, those eyes, that mouth.
And, of course, all those ladies right there are the products of the genie's vivid imagination.
Some imagination.
And the genie himself, a cool guy. Now, I'm told that all the girls out, though, have it really bad for their Aladdin man.
That's
this
right.
Aladdin man coming up right now.
He's everywhere.
Okay, Joan and Regis, this is one parade I'll never forget, and neither will Shirley here. Aladdin's Royal Caravan is going to bring lots of laughter and magic to a lot of guests here at the Disney MGM Studios for a long, long time to come. Merry Christmas, everybody! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas, Joan, Regis, John, Leanza, and everybody watching. It's been a great, great day. Listen, how would you like to be on Star Search?
Go behind the scenes for a look at Mickey's Toontown from Disneyland in California when we return.
Hey, who can? And we've got much more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade coming your way, including a visit with Santa Claus, all right? But right now, let's go to Main Street for my favorite part of Christmas morning.
What's that, Reese?
I'm sure it's yours, too. Toys. Bunches and bunches of Christmas toys.
Well, you've always been a kid at heart.
Right. I feel like a kid again.
When you come in the gates here, though, you can be a kid at heart. It's like they give you permission. I love the toy soldiers. There are those, and look at the toy horses. Giddy up, guys. The precision is incredible.
Toy blocks, toy soldiers, toy horses. All together here.
Of course, these guys led an army of toys to battle with the wicked Barnaby, remember? Played by Ray Bolger?
That's right. Sure.
One of your favorites was in that movie.
Annette Funicello.
That's
Babes
right.
Babes in Toyland.
However, did you know
that
someone made their film debut in that movie? Somebody that's been on your show before, I think even co-hosted with you.
You're kidding me. Not Kathy Lee Gifford.
And Jillian. Yes, in Babes in Toyland.
Oh, I didn't know
and
that.
And the musical score of that film was also nominated for an Oscar.
Well, they picked the right babe. I'll tell you that.
There are the toy blocks. How'd you like to have to wrap those?
Oh, my gosh. They have great attention for detail in this particular part of the parade. These people are well, well rehearsed. Yeah, we love those toy soldiers, Joan. I mean, I just love this parade. Just being here, you're right, makes me feel like a kid again.
Well, here's something to make you feel like a tomb. Let's take a visit to Disneyland out in California, where all the magic started, of course, more than 35 years ago, and a sneak peek at Mickey's Toontown. Now, this is the first entirely new land there in 20 years.
At Disneyland in Anaheim, Mickey's Toontown residents are just putting the finishing touches on their very own land. And we went along as a selected group of non-Toon guests got a special sneak peek behind the scenes.
Oh my goodness, Mickey, they're here!
Oh, we better hurry, Minnie!
And who better to give us the special Mickey's Toontown tour than Walt Disney Imagineers Dave Burkhart and Joe Lancicero, two guys who've been a driving force in bringing Toontown to life.
Toontown absolutely brings out the kid in everybody. If Disneyland allows you to become a child, this place is going to validate that 100%.
Here at Toontown, we can literally have the experience of walking through the movie screen. And suddenly, there we are in Toontown.
A living, breathing cartoon community.
More than just a community, but a complete Toon land that's certainly different than anything you've ever seen before.
Well, it's different because no straight lines are allowed in Toontown. Everything is tuned out.
But don't get the wrong idea. City planning is serious business in Toontown.
It's like a whole little city. You got your civic center here, and then we have a suburban neighborhood where the characters really live.
And of course, connecting the two areas is Mickey's Toontown rapid transit system, the Jolly Trolley.
In a cartoon, if you had a trolley, it would travel crazily down the track. Well, we couldn't do a wobbly track, so we did a wobbly trolley.
One thing's for sure, you won't find any ordinary tract houses in this crazy land.
Well, Mickey's house is the most imposing structure here in Toontown, since Mickey, of course, is our leading citizen.
Behind Mickey's house in his movie barn, Steamboat Willie is just one of the movie sets you can walk onto to meet Mickey in person. Get Mickey's autograph and pose for a photo. You can even explore his house, a real Toontown treat.
Here in the movie barn today.
And here we are at Minnie's house. This sweet and charming little house reflects Minnie's sweet and charming little personality. I think every little girl on the planet will die to go into Minnie's house.
You can help Minnie bake a birthday cake for Mickey. And help out around the house. And on the personal side,
you can go into her dressing room. She has perfume bottles on her makeup table, and each one has a different scent. Strawberry, chocolate, and bubblegum.
Chip and Dale from the Rescue Rangers have also taken up residence in Toontown in, what else? A Toon tree.
The fun here is guests are able to jump in, dive, swim, throw the acorns around.
Donald Duck's nautical past is reflected in his Toontown home, the Miss Daisy. And it has some fun surprises for young Disneyland guests. Toontown architecture seems to match the characters that live there, so it's easy to guess whose Goofy house this is. The fun begins with a stroll through Goofy's garden, which leads into Goofy's bounce house. It's the world's biggest, most elaborate bounce bag.
Everything from the fireplace to the doors to the lamps are available for you to bounce off, just like Goofy does.
One of Disneyland's newest Toon stars, Gadget, has created a thrill ride right in her own backyard called Gadget's Go Coaster. Mickey's Toontown prides itself on letting guests create a lot of fun for themselves.
You cannot come into Toontown and not become part of the action.
And nowhere is this more evident than downtown Toontown.
You can push a button here. You can turn a knob. You get to be part of it. Underneath all the silliness of the gags and everything else, what's basically here is a family experience. There's something here for everybody. When you come to Toontown, you come as a family. Everyone has something to do.
For guests visiting Disneyland in California, Mickey's Toontown is the ultimate chance to become a Toon. So get ready for the official opening on January 26th. And Merry Christmas from Mickey's Toontown in Disneyland.
Coming up next, Miss America with a very special Around the World Christmas at EPCOT Center.
There's Typhoon Lagoon, and you need some water around on a day like this. We are coming to you live today from Walt Disney World. It's a very Merry Christmas Parade. It is a gorgeous day. I don't mean to make you feel bad wherever you are, but it's hot here.
It is very nice, and we can hardly catch our breath. One big Christmas morning, and we've still got a lot more coming your way.
It is an exciting day all across the fabulous resort, all 27,000 acres.
And especially exciting to me, Joan, because once again, I think we may see John Davidson get his hair wet. I mean, if he's at Typhoon Lagoon, and what a head of hair he's got. This is Disney's incredible water adventure park where we've cooked up a little surprise
for
our very adventuresome John Davidson. Let's take a look.
Okay, Scott, are you ready? Everybody help him out. One, two, three. Hit it, Scotty, baby. This is great. Well, here we are at Typhoon Lagoon. This is Disney's unbelievable water park. Isn't it a fantastic place?
Yeah!
You've got water slides, you've got streams, you've got beaches, wave machines, and this thing. It is called Humunga Cowabunga. Let me explain. This is a 51-foot mega water slide. 30 miles an hour, a human body will fly down this slide before it hits the water below. Now, we have time for one more person to do it. Would you like to be next?
No.
Would you like to be next? No. Now, who's going to be next?
You.
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 No.
You.
Regis.
You.
Regis,
you.
Thank you.
You.
Wait a minute. I want to show you how this should be done. Okay, I will do it, all right? This should be done with dignity, right? When you go down, you don't scream, do you, or anything like that?
No, never.
And I will not either. Do you scream?
No, I don't scream.
Girls don't even scream?
No, we don't.
All right. I don't scream either. Watch this. Watch and learn. Incredible. Oh, Regis, you're next. I'm telling you, that is incredible. But that's the old show. Let's get back to see what's happening at Walt Disney World. Very Merry Christmas Parade. Oh, mercy.
Somehow, Reg, I just sensed that you had a hand in that. Am I right?
I'm never going to admit that, but I do enjoy seeing him tugging at his bathing suit like 75 degrees now, still going up.
And this is the Toy Factory making its way down Main Street. Looks like they're already making Teddy Perry for the next Christmas. Look at him. He was okay. I'm so glad that he wasn't hurt in that water slide accident.
Indefatigable, irrepressible Goofy. Can't stop him. Can't keep him down.
Do you know that Goofy's original name was Dippy Dog? I'm glad they changed it.
Oh, absolutely.
He made his debut in a movie called Mickey's Review in 1932.
Mm-hmm. And incidentally, I think I caught him in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade this year as well. He's a bigger-than-life character over here.
Well, he's had a really big year. I mean, he debuted in his first television series, Goof Troop, this year.
That's right. He just turned 60 years old.
That's right. He doesn't look like it. Look at Raggedy Ann and Raggedy Andy there.
Jack in the Box.
And right behind is the toy train. This is one of the parade's most colorful floats. We have this here every year.
A nonstop trip from the North Pole to deliver toys to the boys and girls all over Florida.
Roger Rabbit.
that maroon cartoon, the biggest star. Hey, do you know his newest picture is called Trail Mix-Up? It's currently in production.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, Disney MGM Studios theme park.
He asked everybody to please have a happy holiday.
And there's that shot again, up on the very, very tippy top of the Christmas tree, which is at the bottom of Main Street, 80 feet tall.
I got my watch out! I won't cry!
Another great movie, Who Framed Roger Rabbit? A real box office champion. That was in, what, 1988?
Yeah, and that was an enormous hit, wasn't it?
It won 4 Academy Awards. Film editing, sound effects, editing, visual effects, even a special achievement award for the director of the world.
Well, there's a lot going on in that shot, isn't there? The clown bandits arrived.
They're clowning around out there.
Silliest bunch of serious musicians you'll ever meet. And they all come in just one little car, if you can imagine.
Dressed, of course, in green, red, and white for Christmas.
And with all of their instruments, how do they do it?
Look at all the people lining the street. Look at that boy's block.
Raggedy Ann and Andy. Yeah, the people come from all over the world. One fellow down there from Japan.
Ah, she had her little Christmas sweater on today.
All right, did I tell you this? I mean, did you hear it from me or not?
What?
The very best Merry Christmas parade we've ever had.
I don't know if they told us that yet.
And they tell me the one and the only, Santa Claus. Yeah, Santa Claus will be with us shortly.
And wait until you see what's next, Ridge. Miss America, somebody he knows, 1993, Leanza Cornett. She's going to be with a remarkable group of children, the Walt Disney World Children's Honor Choir. And these are kids from 5 different counties here in Central Florida. And under the direction of Dr. Bert Perenchief, they've put together an EPCOT Center Christmas around the world. So let's all watch this very special musical greeting from Leanza and her friends.
Us together as we sing along the around the world Christmas song. Every time we show love to others, we're building a world family. Could it be we're all sisters and brothers, placing our stars on the same Christmas tree? Around the world, Christmas is lighting our way. The comfort it brings gives us hope every day. Rejoice with the bells that have rung for so long. The around the world Christmas song.
Children, evergreens and sleigh rides too. Carols, shining lights and joy brand new.
This is a magic time when dreams do come true. It's a sparkling
lots of cheer, fish
Wherever you are, Santa Claus is on his way with the grand finale to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Welcome back, everybody. Coming to you live on a gorgeous, picture-perfect day here in Florida.
You're looking there at the Polynesian Hotel there.
Yeah, the Polynesian Hotel.
It
one of the great resorts.
It is a beautiful
here.
Day.
Just a few minutes away from the grand finale of this Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
And you can feel the excitement in the air. The crowd is kind of buzzing with anticipation.
Because everybody in senses a very important arrival.
That's right. I don't know. Like, we're going to have to go down to John Davidson. He's actually on Main Street right now. Are you there, John?
John?
Well, we're standing here in the crowd. I think everybody realizes that Santa is on his way, big guy. Did you know? Did you see him down there? He's coming. Now, what? Now, this is a whole family ride, and you're here at Disney World. What did you get for Christmas? What is the Christmas gift?
Come to Disney World.
So, yeah, did you do a tree in the room? So underneath the tree, anything under the tree at all?
Watches.
Oh, you got new watches, Mickey Mouse watches. Great, okay. Now, everybody's wondering, you know, Regis Philbin is going to celebrate, well, he's celebrating Christmas today. What do you think Santa would put in Regis Philbin's stocking? You know, it's important to be a good little boy and girl, right? What do you think they would put in Regis Philbin's stocking?
I think he should have got a muzzle.
Really?
Yeah.
He's going to love that! And Joan Lunden's going to like it even better. We'll be back to the parade. Regis, I hope you've been a good little boy, have you?
Not a chance, John. Not a chance. A muzzle.
A muzzle, huh? Well, here's what I want for John Davidson. A haircut and a new sweater. I'm tired of that sweater.
Hey, look who's coming. I know that house. That's where Mrs. Claus lives. And there are all the dancers out in front and the candy canes.
The candy house, yes, indeed.
The little candy house. You know, every January, Mrs. Claus puts Santa on a special diet. A little shake for breakfast, a shake for lunch, and a sensible house.
And every year, she gets a little cuter looking, too, Mrs. Claus.
He is very kind to her.
Building up to a big finale here.
There she is.
If Mrs. Claus is around, he's going to be around too. The dancing gingerbread men.
Gingerbread men.
Yeah. Huh. I've been down there on the street, Joan, with the crowd, and when this part of the parade comes, I mean, everybody just, this is thrilling to it.
Look at the little girl. And there are the dancing Christmas trees. No one really knows for sure when the Christmas tree tradition got started, but it first appeared in literature about 400 years ago.
That's what I like working with you. You know everything.
Well, Santa must be close behind, and this year, Regis, we wanted to be absolutely prepared for his arrival. So we learned everything there was to know about Santa. We even went so far as to ask a few Santa experts just to describe him for our cameras.
Well, he has a red hat with a little white thing on top, and he has red pants. And he's being fashioned.
He has rosy cheeks.
Well, he's got grey hair growing out underneath his hat, and he's got a massive long beard like that.
He has a red hat with like a snowball on top. It's not a snowball, but it's a fluffy ball.
Chubby, red nose, white beard.
Well, it's hard to explain.
He looks like my friend named Ross.
I don't know.
Santa Claus. For centuries, folks have been trying to describe just what Santa Claus looks like. Is he a grandfatherly type, a kindly old saint, a jolly old elf with a round little belly that shakes when he laughs like a bowl full of jelly? We know he makes his rounds each Christmas Eve, but how many people have actually seen him? Some say that back in the early 30s, Hayden Sunbloom, an illustrator assigned to create an original painting of Santa Claus for use in Coca-Cola's Christmas advertisements, may have actually seen Santa. Sunbloom's Santa was just as he should be, jolly, roundish, ruddy, nearly 6 feet in height with an impish quality that endeared him to all. And when the public saw this painting, they knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. And so to this day, it is the Sunbloom Santa, created for Coca-Cola over 50 years ago, that has come to be the real picture of Santa Claus, radiating the warmth, kindness, and generosity that is the true spirit of Christmas.
And there
he is. Look at that face. That's exactly how he looks in all the pictures.
Jolly old Saint Nick.
And he's beginning a well-deserved vacation here. As he was going over one of the houses, the Disney people said, and where do you want to go when all this is over?
What do you think he said?
I want to go to Disney World!
Well, he'll have a nice vacation
here. Look at that Santa camp.
No, not a Santa camp, too.
Even a Santa camp.
Well, he put in a long night. He deserves it all today.
What a great face. Looking right up there, the Santa cam picture.
And he didn't forget me. He left something in my room last night. Not exactly what I wanted, but he was there. I appreciate it.
Hey, there are the reindeer, Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen, and of course, Rudolph.
And who are these? The Glock girls?
The Glock girls.
Yeah, sure.
They're carrying sacks of toys to all the little boys and girls.
Yes! What a beautiful crowd we have here today at Disney World! Yes!
What a great parade this has been!
Absolutely the greatest! And look, who just made it back?
Well, I didn't want to miss the opportunity of wishing everyone a very, very Merry Christmas, and neither could my wife, Rhonda.
Merry Christmas!
And Ashley?
Merry Christmas.
From the Davidsons, Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas, everybody, and thanks for watching. And thanks to Ed McMann, Leanza Cornett, and this guy right here, John Davidson.
And, of course, for me and my daughters, Jamie.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. How about you, Sarah?
Merry Christmas.
Very good. And Lindsay?
Merry Christmas.
We want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. Brought to you by Alka-Seltzer. For the way you live today, you'll feel better fast with Alka-Seltzer. And Dayquil Liquid Caps. For non-drowsy, stuffy head, congested chest, sore throat, coughing fever so you can cope medicine. And Kissimmee St. Cloud, Florida. The vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction. Air transportation provided by Delta Airlines, the official airline of Walt Disney World and Disneyland. Delta loves to fly, and it shows. Talent accommodations provided by the many Walt Disney World resort hotels. There's only one thing better than visiting the Walt Disney World Resort, staying there. On behalf of the entire Walt Disney World family, this is Dick Tufeld wishing you a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year.